we say there are three tenses. Okay, of a verb, that is the present tense, the past tense, and the future tense. Okay, so we are going to see this today in this chapter. Let's see. Now we have to follow in page 81. Tense, first person, second person, third person. In case of simple present, we say I eat rice. In case of simple present, second person, we say you eat rice. And simple present in third person, we write she eats rice. Similarly, there is difference in simple past and simple present. Now we will see when we use simple present tense or which sentence tells us that it is a simple present, simple past, or simple present. Okay, let's see that. Now simple present tense expresses something that is always or generally true. Something that is true, like universal truth, which you cannot change. Okay, it's a fact. So simple present is used that way. For example, the moon is round. We know that it's a universal fact. Or the earth rotates around the sun. That is something that's a fact. Okay, or it's a general truth. So that can be used simple present tense. Also, we use simple present tense to describe something that is almost permanent. Okay, or has been happening for some time and is still continuing. For example, living in formula. So that is almost permanent. Now you will be staying here in formula and it has been happening for a very long time and is still continuing. We use that type of simple present tense. And also we use simple present tense to refer to something that happens regularly or something that somebody does out of habit, habitual. Okay. Like a horse needs, that is his habit. Okay. He reads a lot of travel books, that is kind of a habit. Now, let's move to simple past. Simple past tense expresses an action that has already been completed in the past. That is what simple past is. An action that has already been completed, done. Certain forms of the root word indicating past time, such as yesterday, indicates about past. What was yesterday? So, time then, a week ago, 4 months ago, are usually added to sentence describing past action. It's so yesterday. That is your past action, time then. Okay. The past is used, also used to indicate a habitual action. In the past. Again, habitual action, but wrong in the past, not now. My mother always wore a scarf. Now, let's move to simple future tense. Expresses an action that will take place in the future. That might take place in the future. That is what simple future tense is. Words like tomorrow, next week, next month, next year may be used to suggest future time. For example, I shall do my homework tomorrow. That's the future tense. The future tense is always used to state what will happen or will be done as a matter of habit or course. Like I had time or water will bridge this bridge. So that is again, something might happen at a stated point. That is future tense. Nowadays, we use for future tense will instead of shall. No, okay, with all subjects. It is no longer considered necessary to use shall with I and me. Shall I and shall we are still used but to make often the suggestion form. Okay? They are not used to ask a question. Most of the time we use will. Shall I get you a glass of water? It's an option. So that time we can use shall. I am too tired. Shall we postpone the trip? So that is a suggestion. We also use when we decide to do something and the time is speaking. Okay? I will lock the front door. I'm sorry, I'll walk in. Besides using shall and will, we can also use be going to. For instead of am, is, are,